we're gonna get back into the next league.
You too?
I hit double dollar. I had them both flip. My opponent goes like, I have force plus blue card with no lands. And they're like, gamble. And I'm like, oh, I'll just force whatever they gamble for. They gamble for a tabernacle. And I was just like, duh. And that one sucked. That was just purely my fault. No other way around that. Disruptive deck, which is what I like to do. All right, join match. I think I just played against this guy. Yeah, I think I just played against my opponent. All right, I'm gonna keep my hand. Kind of weak to if my opponent goes turn one shaman. So I think I'm gonna sandbag this. Give this one turn. Because like they might not have an answer to this, I might draw a pyro answer. And like there's basically nothing that my opponent can do here to change my play, I don't think. We're hopefully untap the shaman. So this is probably just have to bolt the label right now. I could just like
That's good.
I think I'm just gonna untap. I think I'm just gonna like eat with Shaman. I should have eaten an instant there, that was stupid. My opponent can play Snap Caster Mage. Yeah, so now we're playing for that upstairs game. I kind of want to just eat this Fatal Push right now, and I think I'm going to do that. The Bolt Wipe on the end of the turn. Untap, they're going to go 6. Untap, try Bolt them again. Ask ourselves. I kill them in 2 turns. Give them 2 draw steps. Yeah, I think we're just gonna take this. We're gonna sandbag both these lightning bolts. And we're gonna fire them off that next turn with a non-tap. That was a good top end. So now 3. So I'm just gonna wait with the shaman. Because it's 3 there with a bolt. Untap. Attack. But then the 4 bolt them. Then they go to whatever it is. They go to dead. So that was a good top end. This Marsh Casualties is like kind of medium, but it's just to like kind of relieve some pressure of Baleful Strix in their own true names. I'm forcing him. like, means I have to hold on to this probe, but... play this fetch land, because we have a wasteland on top. There's a chance that we'll want to get rid of it, but I'm not super sure. So let's see what my opponent does here. Flamestorm, okay. So if opponent fetches a basic here, I'm probably going to shuffle crap protection. Alright, now I think I'm just going to go Death Ray. I'm going to go Wasteland. And then Bolt this. And then next turn I can play Angler. Force back up. Which I'm all about. But looking at that means my opponent might not have very many more lands. Because, like, he easily could have gotten a basic there, and then maybe they have a card like Liliana in their hand, or they have, whatever the dumb card is. True Name, or Leovold, which is like a mana restricted card. All these cards are good. I think. Like this pitch is here. This kind of, you know, helped us fix up, and this is a good removal spell. Alright, we're getting nasty over here. Okay, so now we're gonna brainstorm. I'm probably going to do it on my main phase, because I might hit like a Delver or a Death Ray. Which we didn't do. But I actually can just shuffle it away, so it's not that bad. I'll shuffle away the second probe. As this team ends. Yep, so we'll just go like this. I can't remember if the angler's on top, because it's actually like pretty realistic that we can get to another angler. Yeah, I don't think I force this. Yeah, I'm just gonna fetch. Then look to just pat, look to just push through this true name. This and eat my opponent. So let's go with this. They probably ditch the Strix. No. They're like, this guy's got Gurmag Angler written all over him. I could have gotten the true name down, but I think I just want to beat face. Now like a Bolt's lethal next turn, which we've got a bunch of them left in the deck. our opponent off of a green land. And then play True Name. True Name's lethal next turn. Against that guy, that Sultai deck today. Which always feels good. 11 viewers, I appreciate you guys all showing up and hanging out today. If you guys like to see, please hit the follow button. If you guys want to support me more, go over to my YouTube channel and hit the subscribe button there. It's free and it's like that's the best way to support me. I always upload all my streams, I'll have these two leagues up after the day. Check me out on Twitter. That's where I was talking about Magic. Talk about all the formats. I think all the formats are pretty good right now. And you should support Cardholder. It's the best spot game in the business. You should check out Gamer Craze, which is a store I learned to play Magic at. And their Crystal Commerce is linked below. Okay. This is a pretty threat-dense hand. One piece of interaction. We're looking probably at the first. This card's like either completely muffed against like half the format or useless. So I think I'm gonna keep it. I think in the dark I've got to keep a hand like this. Cause we can go like Dude Disruption, which you know I'm always about Dude Disruption. Fires this, I think I'm just gonna let that go because I would like to be able to play these true names on three. That's gonna be pretty important in order to getting into this game. Yes, we're never playing against lands. I tossed my lands matchup last round, so let's see if maybe we can figure that out. Zoned out there. I was like, oh, that's good. Right there. Didn't think about that. Not much I could have done. Like, just didn't have a lot going on. So I just get slapped by 2020. So Surgical is where we want to be. I think we want these to deal with, like, Sphere Effects. And the Edicts. Cards I'm not really about are my removal spells. And I probably can cut Nature Meter. I don't think I want anything else. Yeah, let's try this. Hopefully we can just get a fast start going on and then counter like something that's really important, maybe a Wasteland or two. So yeah, I don't know about what I'm supposed to do. matchup is if I'm supposed to like sandbag my wastelands for like their lands that matter, or if I'm supposed to like try to get on the front foot. Yeah, we'll keep this. An active death rite should be able to do some work against this guy, because we have two of them. And we do have like outs, like just the nut draw. We can go like Wasteland Grudge if they go like a Mox Diamond stuff. Is it like, am I supposed to go Wasteland Grudge, you know? Like to harass their mana. Hopefully this shaman untaps here. I get to untap this shaman. Like snap both of these Mox Diamonds with his Ancient Grudges. Like, I'm tempted to just go like bang bang next turn. Wasteland. Okay. Or do I just eat this loan? I probably just eat the loan and then play another Shaman. Choke. Exploration. Okay. We only have three cards in their hand. And we have a wasteland. They have another loam. Okay. Okay, so I think if we can get rid of this loam, we should be able to slow them down quite a bit. If they don't have another land. So I can waste this, play another, I can waste this, play a shaman, or waste this and play a delver. And I think I'm gonna waste this and play a delver. I think I want to like get going with this game. And I'm actually more afraid of the grove. Next turn, I'm just gonna snap both of those mox diamonds off. Actually, I can't snap both of them off, right? Because I need 3 mana to do that. I only got 2. But I can at least start it. My opponent might waste this Ghost Quarter or wasteland this thing, which is fine. It's tough that I'm in one spell a turn territory for a little while, but at least this shaman's making mana for me. And I can't, if my opponent finds a loan. It'll be the third loan, so if they find a loan, we're in trouble. But I think that we're doing okay. This is, do I have to keep the Deathrite Shaman in play, or do I have to keep the Delver in play? I think I have to keep the Deathrite Shaman in play. My gut tells me I need Shaman. That mana to keep this in play, and then next turn play another death rite, and then have 2 death rites going. The death rites do just pay for each other though, which is like not great, but at least we might be able to find a cantrip. I can flashback grudge, hit this, play another shaman, and then have 2 shamans going. And then just kind of hold out and wait for a cantrip to find a wasteland. I think that's what I'm gonna do. I think I'm gonna get this grudge off, get this the back half of this mox off the battlefield. Oh, I boarded out my trap? No way. Oh, he wasted. Oh, he got rid of the trap. Oh, man. So now do I just play both of them? And just try to keep one of them alive with the shaman? If I can find a wasteland, I'm in such good shape. But I have to find a wasteland. I think I'm gonna play both of them. Then I'm going to keep one death rite alive and keep the Delver alive. I guess I could have seen if my Delver was going to flip first. That would have been the proper way to stack that. Stack this better, I could have had
first after 8.
But you want to pay for this Delver. I want to pay for this death rate. We draw Daze, which actually picks a land back up, which can make mana for me. So hopefully my opponent puts something on the stack here. I think I'm gonna get this Delver going and pray for a wasteland. I don't see how I'm winning besides that. Alright, that buys me another turn. So we have another force on top, so I'm going to just fetch. And I think I'm going to get another Vol. Or I'm going to get this Vol here. Let's draw some new cards. Gamble card completion. There's not a lot going on. Wait to bust this tabernacle until I so I just force this, which just slows my opponent down, and they can gamble for Thespian Stage. Now they just get Ghost Quarter, which just buys me another turn. Like, worst comes to worst, I can like draw Delver here, waste this Tabernacle, and then be in the game. Because I've got, what, I've got two Delvers, I have two Delvers, two Deathrite Shamans, one True Nemesis, one Duramag Angler left. Black sources, though, which is good. I just don't think I have an out to this choke, which is my problem. So I know I'm up to that. Probably sacks the forest or the triangle ticket. Yeah, so he's going to load it back and then for value. I can't play spells the rest of the game. Then I can wasteland this, and then they just go play Dark Depths, gamble, and then they just start roaming that. Yeah, we're dead. I don't think I have any ways out of this. Yeah, we just got worked over there. This guy beat me twice today. I would have beat him in the first match. I'd like to watch that and at least be like, why? Where did I go wrong? Because I feel like I had the tools to win that game. Whenever I play against lands, I always feel like I have the tools to win, but then I just don't. Like, I'm ahead and I'm ahead and I'm ahead, and I feel like I let it go. Forcing a shaman next turn. They decay. I guess I should have fetched the wrong land. My opponent can just play, they can just like go land Abrupt Decay. So I could actually just go Wasteland, hit this black source, play Duramag Angler, force a Deathrite Shaman, and then try to figure it out. Yeah, I'm definitely just gonna force one of these. Hopefully my opponent is gonna win. Thank you. death right, unknown card. So now we just gotta hope that they break here. Then we're gonna brainstorm an army in phase. Play swamp. Still gonna be a shaman. We only have a death chunk. Jesus Christ. I'm gonna put back Delver and then Lightning Bolt because if they hit me, I'd rather than just get rid of this brainstorm. I guess I stacked that wrong. Because like, if I put the brainstorm back, I could have gone like next turn Bolt, play Delver, flip Delver, yeah, that would've been. Get my brainstorm. And then we get brainstorm. We'll definitely just get this guy out of the way here. A tight set of five turns here. I'm gonna worry about a Diabolic Edict, which doesn't really matter. We're just gonna attack, play this Delver, and then they're dead through a blocker next turn. What a tight match. Second time we've been here, we're playing against this Bugbear in this league. Morning, sweetie. Chad, my wife says hi. Alright, bring in this, the Blasts, the Edict, the Dismember, the Liliana. We're gonna cut our Dazes on the draw. And we're gonna cut Spell Pierce. Kind of, we're gonna board the same way we did last time. We're gonna cut one Force and bring in a Marsh Pelican. I do think I want one more grindy card here. But these Spell Pierces do not feel very good, I don't think. I can see one Spell Pierce being a main deck king. Stretch him out. I can take him out after my league's over. Alright, we are going to keep this hand. It's not great, but we have an answer to like a Deathrite Shaman, a Trunian Nemesis, a Cantrip, and a Haymaker. Yes. I would like to blast a Baleful Strix, but like if they play anything but Baleful Strix, it just doesn't feel super great. Alright, so we don't have another blue card, so we're actually just gonna go Force, Pyro, draw the Flooded Strand. Then next turn we're gonna play the Pyromancer more than likely. Though I might like hold it, play Fetchland, hold it, and play Pyroblast because I don't want to get True Name. Okay, so I'm not getting True Name, which is good. I'm totally okay with him wastelanding me because my opponent has like more powerful mana or more powerful cards in their deck. So if they're like trying to disrupt what I'm doing and not doing what they're doing, I think I'm okay with that. and all right. Well, now because we drew that, I still just get wrecked by a Trunia Nemesis. I think I'm just gonna wait. Trunia is just like so bad for the home team. And I could have looked and then resolved Pyro, but like, if the Pyromancer on its own, when they have their own Lilianas, can be kind of not super great. The black cards are really good in these mirrors. This is interesting. Alright, so this play makes me think that they don't have it. And I'm just going to go Pyro Jam this turn. Get a 1-1. We can try to find our Edict. And we're in a position where we might be able to, like, if we can establish a threat, we might be able to wrestle to we might be able to, raise a true name. I wonder if in these grindy matchups, if I'm supposed to bring like Cabal Therapy. Buster Storm. Potentially cut us off Liliana. And we have our own Shaman next turn, so we're gonna go. We can use that decay, so we're gonna go stack it like this. We are gonna have to find another black source, so we can be able to take this game later. But if we find that black source, we're in wicked shape. And again, if my opponent doesn't play a true name here, like, we're in business. Opponent kind of has to Abrupt Decay. Kind of has to Abrupt Decay my Deathrite Shaman. So, and then we're going to Angler. So we have a good set of threats. I probably should have stacked that the opposite way, so I drew Angler. All the micro decisions are so awesome. The Baleful Strix is going to be kind of annoying. Maybe they're pondering into a Deathrite Shaman. Thank you.
one, they have no defenses. Basically not really being a lot. More dead draw step. So what one things work? I assume they still have their own bunch of dead. I'm going to answer the true name. Tight game. Oh, it's just a YouTube playlist there. It's called Red Chair Silent Partner. Just like non-copy. You can find it on YouTube. It's like non-copyright music on YouTube. Sylvan Library. That's going to be a good one. Drawing another dead card this turn. Library doesn't bury us, and if we draw a black source. So we draw a black source, we just start playing Gurmag Anglers, and like that's gonna stop the game pretty quick. I would assume my opponent still has an Abrupt Decay somewhere in the top couple cards of their deck, though they might feel like they're in such a run. I guess the Misty's a good card to use with the Sylvan Library anyways. Okay. So maybe they ditch the Abrupt Decay, maybe they feel like they're that far behind. Plus Jace, my opponent's at 14. He's just going to be too much to overcome, I think. Okay, so on the play, I'm going to cut my forces. And I'm going to bring in these phases. And I think I'm going to cut Fort Bolt. We're going to keep it the same as it is. I still don't know if it's right to board in like Flusterstorm, keep Flusterstorm and Spell Pierces in, because like it seems like all the really important cards are creature spells. Like I'm much more happy about Spell Pierce and Fluster Storm. Fluster Storm seems like it's just not where we should be. Alright, we're going to keep this. We have turn one Shaman. I have to really hope my Shaman doesn't get Fatal Pushed. Best case scenario, my opponent leads on a turn one Shaman as well. Because I don't have a lot of ways to kill a Shaman on one, unless they force it. Because my hand's pretty susceptible. Because like if I kill the Shaman, then all of a sudden I have two cards here that are stranded. So we're gonna do this and we're gonna hold our breath. I don't know if I'm just like not supposed to play the Shaman and wait, but that just seems crazy. It's the best card in my deck. Don't kill my Shaman. Hopefully he just plays his own Shaman. Shaman. Come on, don't kill my Shaman. Damn it. Alright, well, we're definitely gonna waste that. Okay, so they have their own Deathrite Shaman. Okay. They have a loan too. So we're... If they can get there, we're in trouble. We can play an Angler next turn, which is like our best way to win, I think. Land. Fold. Okay. Don't find a land. Okay. Ponder for land. Okay, so here's like the $1 million question. Should I just jam? I don't think I'm going to jam this Angler on this turn. I think I'm going to wait to fetch a red source because I think it's important. And like, I wouldn't mind the brainstorm coming off my deck here. Opponent cleans up. They might ditch loam. Okay. March Casualties, get rid of this Ponder, fetch, play my land, so I don't get Pyroblasted, or so I don't get Forced, fetch in Underground Sea, play this. Cut, I'm going to dump all of my lands to just keep my opponent, gets a Shaman, they have to like fight with their life in the loam. I think this is definitely forceable. Okay, just didn't have it. So now they're dead. We have two bolts, they're at 13, so dead in three. Okay, they're gonna keep it going. They clean up, ditch this Liliana. We'll do another base, which is good. If we draw land, that's just unfortunate draw for them. Like they mulligan. Yeah. Alright, two more matches here, then we're gonna call it a day. My mom's coming down for Mother's Day, so I need to clean the house up and get ready for her. I hope everybody's having a good time with some fun with my mom this weekend. Starting to pick up here a little bit. So if you guys like to see, please hit the follow button. My name is Dylan Huffington. We're on live stream here. I'm part of the Card Order Network. So you can check them out at twitch.tv/cardorder to figure out who's live. Game of Grades is another store of sponsorship. It's where I learned to play Magic. Their Christmas comments is linked below. They buy and sell at a good rate because they foster a college environment. I always put all of my videos on YouTube. If you miss a stream and want to catch something, you should check it out on YouTube. And you can check me out on Twitter. That's where I like to talk about Magic. So, yeah, look there. The best way to support me is to just subscribe on Twitter. Like, that's, you know, or subscribe on YouTube. It doesn't cost you anything, and it helps me get to work on it. And if you do become part of a subscriber to the stream, you get the greatest amount of all time. This is my favorite job in the world. card mana, but we have a Delver that isn't full scroll. If we draw Brainstorm, like, fix all the problems. I'm just going to counter things that I have the opportunity to counter. We got coming off the top. We got Fork Bolt. We have no red mana, though. And, like, it might be completely wrong to daze that card because it seems, you know, it seems not important, but I just don't know what this thing can do here. If my opponent were to, like, smallpox me, okay, now I see what's going on. That is what we were looking for. They just a chalice. Alright, I'm gonna play this land in case we get smallpox again. The nice thing is, if we do get smallpox, we can play, play Nasty or Masty. Hopefully this is like an Inquisition. Yeah, now he's playing Angler. They just hope they don't have an answer to it. Oh, that was a great draw. It's our blue card, which we're gonna keep. And hopefully this Angler just like gets us to where we need to be. I hope the zombie fish does it. At this point, can I race the rack? I think I can race that. I think we're basically just getting rid of anything that kills Gurmag Angler. Like, if it doesn't kill Angler, we're keeping it. Card. Easy one to discard. Move it all in. Streams over. That's gotta go. We'll take two, put them to six. They're gonna be able to chump a lock with their Mistress Factories eventually. They might be able to race us with the factories. Question is, am I supposed to play this card? And I think I am because it's net neutral on cards. Like, it's a cantrip, so, and I might draw like a daze. Then if I have to daze something, that's okay. Just gonna put another card in my hand. Ooh, we're gonna try to draw this Wasteland. We're gonna waste this turn over. My opponent has no black mana. We should cut off most of their draws, I think. I don't know a lot about my opponent's deck. I know a lot about the modern version. I know that the modern version wants to draw. So does my opponent choose to draw? What do they do there? No, I wouldn't die at all. So So now we brainstorm, look for a fetch land. Didn't hit it. Which is fine. I think I'm about to restart. I'm about to sideboard then restart Moto. Of course, on chump block duty, it looks like. Alright, so now I have black mana. Just gonna shut off our Dark Magic Angler. Who got it for you? Wait, no Kira. Okay, I'm gonna sideboard here, then I'm gonna restart Moto. Or if my wife calls it now go. So against this deck. I don't know what I'm supposed to, probably want like this. Might want anything that gets grindy. These cards kill the rack. And Mishra's Workshop, I believe. Probably don't need my removal. So maybe I want to go like this. I really don't. I kind of want to keep all my counter magic because I don't want, like, their deck is so redundant that I just want to hit the certain cards that matter. And I feel like the cards that matter are like the Rack, Liliana the Veil. So I'm going to submit this. Then I'm going to put my sponsor page up here. And I'm just going to reset Moto as soon as this checks out here. It doesn't necessarily feel like that in Modern, because it's difficult to control your draw step effectively. Like, none of the cantrips are that good. Opt is okay. I don't think Serum Visions is very good. Serum Visions is slow. And also, like, it's so mopey to Serum Visions on turn one. I think I'm gonna... Oh, God, I really don't want to mulligan. I just want to keep any hand that, like, does anything. And I get two draw steps out of land, but I could easily get this hand easily could get like I could just get stuck. Yeah, there's just a chance I don't play magic. Alright, we'll keep this. We're gonna put this on the bottom. Nice thing is that I can play Shaman and have Force up. Thank you. I force this, I'm gonna lose to smallpox. If I don't force this and play my shaman, yeah, I mean, they're just gonna take my ponder or my shaman. My diabolic edict. That's odd. Why would you take my edict? Are they playing like? Do they play the Dark Depths Vampire Hexmage combo here? I can't figure out why my opponent did that. There's anybody in the chat that knows why, you should tell me. That makes me think that they have Hexmage plus Dark Depths in their deck. Which is like pretty okay when I have a shaman. I should have, this is a mistake, I should have used the shaman. I think I'm just gonna draw this brainstorm so that I can catch up the forest. I'm not gonna be using my mana, so we'll just get in there. Shaman's getting in the red zone. Wasteland, okay. Alright, so now we're going to exile land. Make blue mana. Brainstorm. Well, this is probably pretty good. Like, if we can just get this true name down, I should be in pretty good shape. I think I'm just going to play this land and pass. Like, force pitch ponder. Next turn, I'll play true name. I hope I stack those right. I don't know if I stack those right. There's a factory, okay? Didn't stack them right. Really? I'm just being lethargic with my ponder. I think I'm just gonna pass. I wanna get my land. We have double force up. If I land this true nemesis, I'm feeling like I'm in pretty good shape. I'm gonna force anything that's relevant here. And then I'm gonna force. But like I know there's a land on top, so I want my land. Mirroring Mistress Factory, the Joker Bob on the stack. Sounds good, dude. Actually affected because like the opponent doesn't do anything here. I go to 16 off of like I attack them, they go to 19, I go to 13, then they go to 16, I go to 16, so it's 15. So I guess I'm gonna win this race eventually. So yeah, I'm definitely attacking. Set up. No, I can't let something like Liliana resolve because came up something like Lumiona Resolve, because then they'll just, I can't like make a token to sack the token to an edict. We're in pretty good shape, I think. I don't play this format. I don't play it often, but I have a really good time. Actually, it makes it lethal through a block next turn, so we're gonna... I'm not quite lethal, I'm one short of lethal. I find a removal spell that I'm good. Draw these in reverse order. I don't think they play a sweeper. If they do play a sweeper, I'm gonna find out. Oh, they could easily play the Marsh card. The Marsh Casualties. This is all stupid. Yeah, I potentially toss this. The Marsh Casualties puts my opponent in the game. That was stupid. They drew Wasteland, okay. What does Wasteland do? Wasteland, they block. Didn't play around Marsh Cactus, and it doesn't appear like I'm going to be punished, but they block this, they take 3, 5, 6, Shaman, 8, 10 out of the game. This deck's very good. But I don't play a lot of Legacy, and this deck is like carrying me. Stupid of me playing the Marsh Casualties out. Because I could have easily rebuilt. Marsh Casualties plus Liliana would have been annoying, but they didn't have the lands to do that. So this for one. I will eat your smallpox. And then call it a match. So we got one more match, and then I'm done for the day. Going for the 4-1, so hopefully we get the profit here. Hopefully we get the profit. Get the 4-1. So I went 2-1 good today against the Bug deck. And I went 0-2 against the Lands deck. And I lost once to Storm. Which I feel like I had the tools to beat Storm. I just didn't draw what I needed to in the sideboard. It frustrates me that against the Lands deck, I just tossed it. Unless my opponent had the Tabernacle in their hand. Thank you. save the probe for the Pyromancer. That seems kind of Windmourish, though. I think I'd rather have this information. I could find a Deathrite Shaman or a Delver. We have to play that. Okay, so they're playing. I think this one's called the Epic Storm. And I actually can't ponder because if I don't find a blue card, I'm gonna die, I think. Right? Dark Ritual. One, Chrome Mox, Ditch, the Ponder, Ditch. Do I just die? If I don't force, if I only have Force of Will, I probably die to like a black, probably die to a red card. Isn't they just Infernal Tutor for something? So yeah, let's pass the turn. Let's take it slow. I can waste my opponent next turn. I think the longer this game goes, the better it is for me. What's that? Okay. This is the last match, so. This kills two creatures. This kills three creatures. So I think we're just going to. This is kind of unfortunate. I don't think I want this Daze. I do think I want this Pyromancer. So I'll draw Pyromancer. This turn. Next turn, crack this, get another red source, and then like play Pyro. Yeah, so we're gonna go. this. No. I guess hit the red. So I trade out 2, I take 8. Next turn, I bolt, and then I take 8 again. Or I bolt one of them, make 2 more tokens, so then there's 7. Too close. As well, we're going to keep. We're going to look for a land, basically. Coming for you. Sending a message here. I'm about 100% waste of something here. If they give me the opportunity. Wasteland, I'm just gonna shoot this thing off. Okay. Nice thing is that as soon as my opponent gives me priority, I actually can surgical something. Just to show me what they're doing. I kind of just want to surgical this probe and know what's up. So I can figure out what I should be doing. This might be loose. But I just want some information. Wow, they had a probe in their hand. Thank you. Burning Wishes. They have an ad nauseum as well. Oh man, I hate how they do this. They have Ponder, Light, or two Ponders, Light, and Mons. Original Electric Catch. Probably gonna have Exile and Ponder. There's something like that. Let this go, right? They have another one. They have Ponder, Rite of Flame, Chromon. Yeah, I think we're just gonna let this go. We just need a land. We need a land off the top. Maybe I should bring Grudges in at the next game. Like, they rely so heavily on this. That's the thing. Not shuffle. Hopefully it's a red land. Red land lets me get down this Pyromancer, and then if we get any other, you know, counter shenanigans in good shape. I wonder if that's actually right for me to search for on that turn. Rite of Flame and one more card. Rite of Flame doesn't make it on the end. It shows the match up. Yeah, I was going to let this go. Probably Therapy My Force. There's Rite of Flame and then whatever's coming off. One more card and whatever's coming off the top. Whatever's coming off the top from there. Okay, we need a land. That's tough. And we kept a six land hand where our only land is a wasteland. We had a Surgical and a Force. Infernal Tutor. This probably gets Rite of Flame, but they can't cast anything. Yeah, so they have two Rite of Flames. Yeah, this is tough. This is gonna be a tough way to go out. But I don't know. Okay, so they don't have anything. I don't have red mana, okay. Alright, that's a good draw. Like if we're not gonna hit land, then we're gonna hit forces. Forces, they have two red hands. Force the way they get rid of mana. That's how we should do it. We can just peel. They shuffle their library. Okay, so this makes force this. They have one more right to find. They gotta have the card that we're going for here. Let's pitch this over. I should have not done that. Get rid of that. And we got nothing. Rite of Flame. I'm going to assume that they have empty ones in their hand. Yeah, this was dumb. It was dumb for me to pitch the Delver because, like, I think it's right for me to wasteland the Vault. Yeah, see, now I'm super finished. Delver flips. Or maybe I have to like shuffle and brainstorm. I think I'm gonna bring an ancient right this one. I have to find my marsh casualties. I can find my marsh casualties. They probably have enough gas to do it again. I feel like I could have played this match better. For sure. But there's something more that I could have done. Start cracking those pedals, but it shouldn't be a problem. Yep, there's all that. This brainstorm's gone. This right thing's gone. This right thing's gone. Storm to kill me in one. Okay, no. It's conservative, it looks like. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Million, yeah, okay. I think I tossed that. I think there was a way that I could have interacted better in that game. I don't know. I feel like whenever I lose these storm decks, that it's my fault. I think there's something that I could have done differently. You know? Like, I always feel like I have the tools, but it just doesn't work.